Standing just a few hundred yards from its original location at the mouth of Ketchikan Creek, this replica of the original Chief Johnson totem pole was commissioned by the Tlingit Tongass tribe and funded through a grant from the state of Alaska. The pole is made from a single western red cedar log and stands 55 feet tall. The original Chief Johnson pole stood from 1901 until 1982. Its replacement, raised to reinstate the people's claim to the land of their ancestors, was raised on October 7, 1989. In a community where dozens of totems once stood in the downtown area, when the Chief Johnson replica pole was raised, it was the first authentic totem to be carved and raised in a traditional manner in downtown Ketchikan in more than 50 years. The pole, carved by Tlingit master carver Israel Shotridge, was his first solo, large-scale totem. Another one of his works, the Chief Cheyenne Totem, stands on the corner of Bawden and Mill Street in Whale Park. The pole depicts the creation of salmon and the legend of Fog Woman. Like many legends passed down from generation to generation, totems often memorialized native lore. The story of Fog Woman and the creation of salmon is shared by Tsimshian native Margaret Bolton.
A long, long time ago, Raven and his two slaves built a camp at the mouth of a creek. As winter approached, Raven and his slaves went out fishing for food to last the camp through the cold season. Raven caught only bullheads and started to make his way back to camp, empty-handed. But as they paddled their boat back to shore, a great fog rolled in. Raven and the two slaves were lost. Suddenly, a woman appeared on the boat. Neither Raven nor his slave saw her approach, and all she did was ask for Raven's spruce hat. He obliged her request, and she gathered the fog into the hat as though it were a basket. Raven took Fog Woman back to camp and married her. Since his camp still didn't have food for the winter, Raven planned another fishing trip. This time, only one slave accompanied him. The other slave stayed at camp with Fog Woman. While Raven was out fishing, Fog Woman got hungry and ordered the slave to fill a basket with water from the creek and bring it back to her. She dipped her fingers in the water and told the slave to dump the water in the sea. He did, and as he was doing it, he found a sockeye salmon. The slave cleaned and cooked and ate the fish with Fog Woman. Fog Woman told him to clean his teeth so that Raven would not know about the salmon they had eaten. But the slave did not clean well, and Raven was very smart. He saw the meat in his slave's teeth and asked how it got there. The slave lied, telling Raven that the meat was from a bullhead. Raven pressed on and asked again and again until the slave admitted that Fog Woman had allowed him to find a salmon. Raven called out to Fog Woman and asked her about the salmon. Instead of explaining, she asked him to fill his spruce hat with water from a stream and bring it back to her. She dipped four fingers into the water and dumped it out. Four salmon fell out of the water. Raven, Fog Woman, and the slaves ate good dinner. But the people needed more salmon to survive the winter. Fog Woman told Raven to build a smokehouse and fill a basket with water from the stream. He did both of these things, and Fog Woman washed her hair with the water and told him to empty the water into the spring. The spring became saturated with salmon. Raven and his people caught and cleaned enough fish to fill the smokehouse, and there were still enough fish remaining to fill it again. Raven was happy. His people were well fed, and there was ample food every winter, thanks to the constant supply of sockeyes. As time went on, Raven got careless and began to talk carelessly to Fog Woman. They fought, and he struck her. She told him that she would leave and return to her father's house. As she left, a strange sound like the wind came from the smokehouse, and Raven realized that she was serious. Raven ran off after Fog Woman. He tried to grab her, but his fingers passed through her as easily as they would through water. Fog Woman continued to walk, and the salmon followed her. Raven told his slaves to save some of the fish, but they were not strong enough to hold them. Raven and his people no longer had an infinite supply of salmon, but Fog Woman is not cruel. She sent her daughter, Creek Woman, with a basket of water she has touched every year. The salmon come from this basket, and the people always have enough fish to eat. End of story.
Many tribal elders, dignitaries, Haida, Tlingit, and Tsimshian people from throughout the Northwest Coast came to celebrate the Chief Johnson Totem's raising. A traditional potlatch feast to commemorate the event followed the pole raising. The guests were treated to a traditional salmon dinner with many native dance groups performing into the early morning. True to tradition, along with the feast, speeches, native adoptions, and name-giving were included as part of the pole raising and potlatch ceremony.